sporting, motivational, entrepreneurial, travel, music, also who just have an interesting story.
All right, guys, so I suppose today we're joined by Jenny's Munch.
Hello.
Jen O'Leary, aka Jenny's Munch, I should have said. So, Kev, do you want to start us off?
Yeah, so every week we start off with a bit of rapid fire, just some fun questions, this or that kind of thing. So we'll start with your favourite TV show.
Grey's Anatomy.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Is that still going?
Yeah, I love it. I haven't watched it in ages, but definitely favourite.
Yeah. I used to be on before Desperate Housewives or something.
Yeah. But your favourite music artist at the moment?
Hudson's 82.
Never heard
of him. No, same.
I'm seeing him at Box Off soon.
Oh, yeah.
Your perfect Saturday night?
At a festival. Nice. Techno Deep House Festival.
Big into the festivals.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Were you at Independence or anything recently? Or?
No, I wasn't at Independence, but I was at most of them this summer.
Your biggest pet peeve?
People that eat really loudly. Okay. Even though everyone would probably say that's me.
Tea or coffee?
Coffee.
Yeah, it keeps you going.
Yeah.
And that one, iced or hot coffee?
Cold brew from Starbucks.
Oh,
yeah.
Very specific.
Yeah.
Do you want to go again? That was a bit rogue from me there.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Insta or Twitter?
Instagram.
Yeah,
I don't really use Twitter that much.
We're the same. We think it's just dead.
It's kind of dying. It's very kind of business-to-business kind of thing, like we find with it. Like.
No, it is good if you want to target certain people, but definitely I just use Instagram a lot
Instagram,
more.
Instagram, yeah. The stories and everything are brilliant. Squats or deadlifts?
Deadlifts all day.
Sumo deadlift. Very specific with them all. Your favorite type of blogger?
Someone that's real and that's not just trying to promote and push things that they probably don't even use themselves.
Yeah. And on that one, who would be your favorite actual blogger? Would you have a favorite?
Like, I wouldn't even say that I have a favorite blogger. Like, I have certain influencers and people that I like watching. But to be honest, they're like Cork-based people that I can identify with. To be honest, I think Nathan Adams is killing it at the moment. He's hilarious. I love watching Nathan's content.
He's a legend, to be fair.
Your favourite cheat meal?
I like cheat meals every single day, like, to be honest. the last year.
We wouldn't call them cheat meals, so.
A dirty Chinese from the Great Wall in Ballincollig.
Very
chicken curry, fried rice, chips and Fanta. Yum.
Like ourselves, we're fond of the cheat meals. Would you be a winter or a summer person?
Summer, definitely.
I'd be the exact same.
Yeah. I'd be winter then. I love winter.
I can't understand it.
Just Christmas, the whole, you have Halloween, you have Christmas, it's just the festivities.
But like when you get up in the morning and it's
I just love the darkness.
Seven
like,
in the morning.
Love
oh,
it. I kind of just embrace it as you wake
you're
up.
You're a weirdo. So I suppose, Jenny, you're like I suppose we see as a fitness or a food blogger, really. How did it all start for you? Where did it all begin?
Well, I certainly wouldn't see myself as like a fitness and food blogger anymore. I suppose when I started off, it was like in third year in college, and it was never a plan to like be I wouldn't even say a blogger, influencer, or anything like that. I was just purely showing people what I was eating and the way I was training. But that has evolved into something so much more now. Like I'm actually like lucky if I get to the gym, and I certainly don't follow a healthy lifestyle that people should be following anymore. Like this was my first week that I haven't gone out like all summer. I love going out. But no, you know, there's some absolutely fantastic people that really are leading in terms of health and fitness that I follow now. But where it started was, I was someone that just wanted to lose weight and be healthy, and I showed people along the way. And I was studying marketing in CIT, and I suppose they came hand in hand. I really loved promoting things, helping things that I used and believed in myself. And then I went on to finishing college and then doing my master's in marketing, and then getting stuck in and involved in a lot of marketing around Cork. That's where it all kind of came off from.
Brilliant. And you kind of started with the food blogging. It was very targeted towards students, helping students like realize that you can eat healthy at a cheap price. But when you started the food blogging, was it always something in your mind you wanted to do? Or you just kind of said, look, I want to lose weight, I'm going to like let people follow this journey
with me. I was never a blogger, like writing blogs. I was kind of storytelling through Instagram and my Facebook page. And I think I just kind of put my personality and just kind of like whatever I thought I'd put up, and it wasn't tailored, you know, where I wasn't hiding who I was. I was literally just putting up what I was doing and just no shit attached.
Yeah.
Just like healthy, cheap student munches, like showing what I was buying in Lidl, showing what I was buying in Tesco, and then translating that through Instagram to other students, and it just gained a massive following.
Yeah, brilliant. And the name Jenny's Munch, is there any inspiration behind that, or was it just
It was, I think, like when I started, I changed the name like 6 times in the first month. Yeah. I was so uncertain. I suppose like at that time, not everyone was doing Instagram. Instagram was just starting, like the Fit Fam and Irish Fit Fam. That was the start of it going back 3 years ago. I don't know. I just absolutely love Munch. It was Jenny's Munch. It was Jenny's Munch for a while. But no, it's Jenny's Munch. It's hilarious. Like it's stuck.
Yeah.
The name Jenny's Munch stuck. So yeah, I'm actually delighted I called it that. 3 years ago.
Yeah, it's cool. Like it's a real kind of Cork kind of feel to it, I suppose.
Yeah,
Munch,
it definitely stands
thing,
out. So. Like, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Munch. All I think about.
And like you started with this, like this journey on Instagram. Was this something you kind of thought when it was picking up, this is something I could go full time on, or were you always just focused on marketing? Like that's where your passion lied, or?
No, like I never wanted to be like a blogger or have my career path based on Instagramming or, you know, social media. I absolutely adored college and loved college, and I knew I wanted to do a master's, and I just finished it. But now my career path is in social media marketing. But if you had asked me that when I started my Instagram page, I would have never thought that I would be what I'm doing or where I am or what I'm doing right now. It worked out pretty good. I worked really hard.
Yeah, fair play. I suppose in your Instagram journey, what do you think was the best thing and the kind of worst thing that might have happened to you throughout that? I know we're putting in the spot here a bit.
No, you're grand. The best thing, absolutely, definitely, like the people that I met through it, be it like owners of companies, people in gyms, friends I met through training, girls that I met from Dublin at like foodie events. These are all like amazing people that I've met along the way. I definitely learned a lot in terms of like, you know, like how you think about things, how you interact with other people. I learned a lot along the way. I suppose the worst thing, there came a point where like I cared too much about what other people thought.
Yeah.
And you get a lot of like overthinking and worry and, you know, putting up something and then deleting it 2 minutes later.
Yeah.
I really went through a phase of really giving way too much of a shit of what other people thought. Whereas now, I really don't. And I think, you know, for anyone else that's starting off on Instagram or Instagramming, no one is perfect, even no matter what you show. And there is a lot of worry.
So like that even happens us, like as you're starting, that's the best attitude to have, because as you start, if we're in the canteen or something taking a story, you're so weary that there's someone behind you.
Yeah.
Just look at the two.
And I'm weary, I keep saying to him, like, don't let it become our lives either at the same time. Like, you know, you don't want to have that be your identity. Like, you know, just take a night off and just forget all about it and all that kind of stuff. Like.
But I think when you're passionate about something and you're being real, like you don't have to go, oh, I have to put something up, or oh, worry.
Exactly.
If it is what it is, put it up and don't worry about it. And like, that's the way I look at now. And I feel as well, like when I'm putting something up, like I want it to like add value to someone, or like, you know, share a special moment in my life.
Yeah.
And I suppose that's kind of the strategy that I'm using going forward.
Yeah, it's definitely the right strategy to use anyway. And you've talked about, you have a big love for marketing. What is it about marketing that just drew you in, like that you just...
Like, what time is it? It's it's 7:30. Like, I don't think I've stopped since 8:00 this morning, and there hasn't been one moment where I've been like, track, or like, what am I doing? Or like, what time is it? I want to go home. Like, I purely get such a thrill of like helping small businesses like realize the potential that they can reach when they implement social media and digital marketing. These are all local businesses. Like, I'm just after moving home from Dublin for a few months before I head off again, and this was my time to chill out, relax, catch up with people, take some chill out time. But it couldn't be the more the opposite. But I can honestly say I'm absolutely loving it. Absolutely loving it. I'm working with some new people. I've got new people on board with me. And yeah, we're ready to make a big impact in Cork over the next few months.
Yeah, keep an eye out, guys. Cool. Keep an eye out.
You see it as a bit of a lifestyle, so not really a job. Like, you know, it's really a passion. Like,
I love it. I absolutely love it. Like, like videography, taking photos, learning new skills. I'm learning something new like every week. I've got some really cool people on board with me who are teaching me a lot. I'm teaching them a lot. So we're ready to make an impact.
Cool. Yeah, definitely.
And you spoke at the Met as a Marketing event run by Jason there recently. How did you find the public speaking, and were you kind of nervous leading up to that or anything, or was it just running
with
it?
To be honest, no. Anyone that knows me is just like, Jenny, shut up. Like, you can't bring me outside the door. I'll talk to every single person along the way. Yeah. Like, no, I am. But I mean, I honestly, and it's such a weird one, and I've talked about it in interviews, I've talked about it to my managers in Dublin. Like, I genuinely believe, like, my confidence in terms of presenting and speaking came from waitressing throughout college.
Oh, really?
I waitressed all through college. I waitressed from the age of 16, and I every day had to present myself in front of tables of people I didn't know. I had to go through the menu. I had to sell the menu. I had to sell, you know, desserts, whatever, on the menu. And I got so confident and comfortable presenting myself. So, I mean, if there's any like girls or lads that are waitressing at the moment, you actually don't understand when you come out of college, and especially if marketing is what you're studying and that's kind of field you want to go into, like, you practice every single time you're talking to a table and you present yourself, and you get so comfortable that when you come out the other side, like, I look back and I'm like, wow, it's genuinely down to or definitely helped was waitressing during college.
And is it something that you want to do more of in the future, just get up and public speak, or?
Oh God, I honestly have no idea what's ahead. It's so exciting. Like, honestly, I don't know, but it's definitely something that I really enjoy.
Yeah.
I do. I like sharing stories. I like sharing insights and experiences. Hopefully I'll have loads more in the future.
Yeah. We were at Amplify Digital Marketing Conference recently, and Steve Bartlett was public speaking, and we made a vlog for a small few seconds, but you were definitely the star of the show.
You definitely shone over us.
How did you find chatting to Steve, and was it kind of inspiring and things like that?
Steve is absolutely... he is literally one of the biggest kind of idols that I have. He's a year, 2 years older than me, and what he has achieved is absolutely insane.
It's unbelievable.
And
yeah,
it's crazy. Purely down to his mindset and how hard he works. He's literally the living, like, marketing god.
Yeah.
I love him. So I had reached out to him a few times on social media, knowing that he was coming over. So I got to meet him after. We had a really good chat. I was an absolute, what I'd say, not a bag of rattles, but I was rattled when I was talking to him. Like, I just couldn't get it together. Like, I was going a million miles an hour. I was like, relax. He was just like, Jenny, relax. Like, I was like, all right, I'm relaxing. He was like, you're not relaxing. I suppose he's a human being at the end of the
day.
He's human at the end of the day. What he's achieved is literally where I'd like to be at some stage in my life. He's absolutely class. Gave me some really, really good advice that I kept with me. And I suppose the main thing is just absolutely go for it, not give a shit what anybody else thinks, and give it your all. And I think that's the main thing I got out of him. Any uncertainty I had, he kind of told me to shut up. I know he's class.
I saw that in the vlog, that he just kept asking you, like, what are you afraid of?
Yeah,
like,
he
can read people so well, like, he just 2 minutes talking chat and he just knows.
And he's
what's
got such
up,
a cool story himself, like, you know, from
coming from
all
nothing,
the pictures he was showing,
like,
that speech and everything are cool, like.
Yeah, it was unbelievable.
He's class.
Like, you touched on your love for Steve. Is there anyone else out there that you'd watch on YouTube, like, any
love
favorite vloggers, like, or anyone else you'd watch online?
Yeah, so Jamie White is doing pretty good at the moment from Dublin. His content's being pushed out. I think he's pretty good. I also really like, obviously, Gary Vee. But, like, to be honest, I'm not saying, I'm not sitting around watching vlogs all the time.
Yeah.
I'm out there doing things. I'm interacting with people who are in Cork, meeting people in and around Cork City, sitting going for coffees, Jason, learning off whoever I can. I think definitely Steve Bartlett's my favorite vlogger by a mile.
And you've plans to move to the Big Apple, I think in a few months' time or whatever. Can you speak a little on that one?
So basically, I've been to New York 4 times now.
Jesus, I haven't even been there once.
The first time that I was there, I was 19, and I literally, from that day, as cliche as it sounds, I was like, I'm working here. Like, I don't care.
I'm going over there.
I've done a good bit of traveling. I've utilized my summers. I've gone abroad. I've seen the world. I've done it, but not obviously all of it, but I've done a fair bit. And there's absolutely nowhere in this earth that gives me the actual rattle bone, like, feeling of, like, I need to work there. Like,
yeah.
I want to work there. I want to live there. So I finished my master's. When I started the master's, it was always in the back of my mind that I wanted to get to New York. I won a student entrepreneurship competition at the end of final year, and I was flown to New York to take part in an entrepreneur competition. Again, that was another massive step for me to be like, this is where I want to be. And then my best friend from my Erasmus is living over there at the moment, absolutely killing it, working in marketing in the city. So I want to get over and join forces with her. Cool. So yeah, look, it wasn't an easy decision.
Yeah, it must be tough to think of it.
I've been up in Dublin. I got some really cool opportunities up there. I've parked them, not forever, but it wasn't easy coming up. Like, and I don't think I'm the only one that gets faced with massive decisions coming out of a master's, being like, okay, where do I live? Do I come back down to Cork? Do I stay in Dublin? I've got a student loan. Where do I go now? This is a really good opportunity. Wow, this is class. Oh my God, will I do it? I think anybody who was around me for the months of April, May and June, I am actually, the fact that they're like still in my life is amazing, because I was single-handedly the most indecisive person ever. Like, I was just, I didn't know what I wanted. Every single conversation I had with myself or with anyone was, okay, what should I do? But look, at the end of the day, I made the decision. I am going to New York. I'm really excited. It's kind of kicked in now that I'm actually going. And yeah, so time won't be long coming. A lot to do and organize before I go. But no, I'm really excited.
Yeah, and like, it's good that you're going this year, because there is talks of maybe the graduate program being stopped. Have you thoughts on that? Or?
Like, I think no one has a clue what is going on in America. But like, whatever, like, you can't base your life decisions based on what ifs or what's Donald Trump going to do. Or, you know, like, if you're even thinking about doing it, just do it. I just think a lot of people are like, oh, I don't know, like humming and hawing about going to America. If you've wanted to do it, just like me, just go do it. You know, the worst that can happen is you're going to go over, you're not going to enjoy it, and you're going to come home. I think it could be a lot worse than 12 months time sitting here being like, oh, I wish I did it, except you're after missing that bracket of the graduate visa. We're in a unique position coming out finishing college that you've 12 months to go over and work in America in the field you graduated in. You can't turn around in 2-3 years time and go, oh, I want to do the graduate visa. I think that's a major factor that played into my decision too. So yeah, I'm like parked with my decision now.
You've bit the bullet and you're going for it. Like,
I'm really
excited. It's the best way to do it.
And speaking of America, have you done any J1 visas in the past over there or anything like that? Or
I spent 3 months in San Diego. The biggest session party 3 months of my life. It's just wouldn't change for the world. Absolutely unreal. So good.
I'd recommend anyone who hasn't gone on a J1, like, just go do it.
It's well,
especially if you're a student, like, for a second year, just go off, do it. The age is 21 to drink over there, but just go over and do it. And what are the future goals for you, your future plans for Jenny? Like, when you go to New York, are you going to sole trade as a marketer? Are you looking to get into a business? Or
no, so my plan is to go over to New York, and I'm going to be absolutely working as much as I can. But I'm going over there to learn. Like, I'm going over there to learn from marketing agencies, from companies, from freelancers, from influencers, from people that I look up to. And learn as much as I can, and come back in 12 months time and change the game in Cork.
I'm looking forward to it already.
And where do you see yourself in maybe 5 years time or 10 years time? Have you long-term goals?
I do, but I don't plan too far ahead. I would never think 10 years. I do see myself being an entrepreneur. I have some really cool ideas that I really want to do, but for right now, I just want to learn off people and learn a lot more. I'm not ready to go out completely by myself right now. That's why New York is number one for me right now.
That's great. And before we finish up, shout out your social media handles for people to follow you along this journey.
So if you want to follow what I'm doing on the lead up to New York and in New York, So my Instagram is at jennysmunch and my Facebook is jennysmunch. And I kind of gone quiet on Snapchat for a while. I just think it's easier to use Instagram stories.
Oh yeah, we love Instagram stories.
But I will be going on to YouTube soon once I get over to New York. Ooh. Stay tuned.
That's an exclusive.
I'll be doing some videos with Use It. And yeah, you'll be seeing more of Jenny.
Brilliant. And the final question I suppose we ask all our guests is, what's Frankly Nuts about Jenny? So to tell you with our brand, I suppose we see ourselves as open and honest and fun and lighthearted too at the same time.
Okay.
So to put you on the spot, what's Frankly Nuts about Jenny?
I'm actually a psycho, like, to
be honest. That's my favourite, like.
Yeah, that's honestly,
I don't stop, like, yeah. Training, meeting people, going out, like, I'll be in the gym all day and then I'll go straight out, like, on a night out, you know. I really have a massive contrast at the moment in terms of what I do. Yeah. No, I still, like, I do eat healthy this week anyway. And I suppose I'm a bit crazy.
Yeah,
we like it.
That's one of our.
And with every guest, we will present you with a bit of glass.
Supplied by Gary McCarthy Trophies.
So there's a bit of glass for your appearance. You can put it up on your mantelpiece and you can take it to New York with you.
Oh my God!
Fits in the luggage.
Yeah.
That is so nice. Yes. Yeah. Thanks, guys.
No hassle.
Your Gary McCarthy Trophies. Thanks, Gary.
Yeah, thanks, Dad.
Oh my God. That's so cute. Cheers.
No hassle.
So, Jenny, thanks very much for coming on.
Thank you.
And we can't really wait to see what the future holds for you.
Yeah,
so,
definitely.
Looking forward to
things ahead for you.
And I just want to say as well, fair play to the 2E because nobody's doing podcasts.
Thanks.
Yeah,
thanks
very much. You're doing it really well.
Thanks.
Cheers.
Thank you. So, guys, make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe.
Everything.
I will see you next time. Thanks very much.
Cheers.